Hey, happy day. 172 of doing one thing every day that makes us happy from the little journal book. Do one thing every day that makes you happy. Today is a top five day. I love these days because they're fun. I love lists and they make me think about what are some of the top five things that make me happy in whatever category it's saying. I don't remember how many we've had of the top fives, but I know we've had a couple this year already. And today's is, handy dandy magnifying glass, the top five animals that make me happy. And then it says, today I played with blank. So pick one of those animals and play with it. Now it's interesting, my top five, a couple of them weren't animals. One, actually, the top two were animals. And the next three, the first time I went through the list were, you know, butterflies and dragonflies, hummingbirds and birds, owls, and then fish. I love to watch fish and aquariums and things. And I'm like, okay, well, none of those are really animals. So let's go back to the animal thing. And I redid it then and I put animals in each one of the things. So I don't know that it matters. It's our exercise. It's what makes us happy. And, you know, I love horses, but fish actually make me happier and more relaxed and make me have a better sense of well-being than horses do. Although, you know, I love all animals. So this was kind of a tough one for me. But go ahead, make your top five list, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, of the animals that you love the most and that make you happy. I guess maybe you don't have to love them the most, but that make you happy or make you laugh or make you smile. My daughter, for example, absolutely is enamored with cows. She loves cows. My aunt, with my namesake aunt, she actually loves pigs, anything little pigs. I love teddy. I forgot, I didn't even write down teddy bears. And I guess because teddy bears are different than real bears, and so I didn't even think of, hey, I love real bears, because I don't really love real bears, but I do love teddy bears and collect teddy bears. But we all have certain animals that we're attracted to and that we find fascinating. Another one my daughter loves is eagles. Again, it's not an animal, but it's something in nature that she finds very amazing and attractive and majestic and beautiful for whatever reason, and it makes her happy. And today, now that I've listed this list, I am going to ask myself, well, why is it that animal or that creature makes me happy or makes me feel good? What is it about that makes me attracted to it? You don't have to do that. That's not the assignment for today in our challenge. It's just, what are the top five animals and which is one that you interact with today? Now, I have cats and dogs are, of course, top one and two on my list because I have cats and dogs. I love them. They love me and I interact with them every day. I put dogs before cats because it's only been the last 5 years or so that I even have had a cat or loved cats. I mean, I was never considered myself a cat person, but I've always loved dogs. I think dogs love us unconditionally, and that's how we should love other people. And it's a great reminder. There's nothing more fun than coming home to the dogs, because it's like whether you've been gone 10 minutes or 10 hours or 10 days, they greet you with the same amount of love as if you'd been gone. And I think maybe because animals don't have a sense of time. Anyway, I don't know. That's the reason why. I just know that they give you unconditional love and that feels good. So what are your top five animals? If you want, share them in the comments below because I would love to know. And I will share mine. I will be brave and share mine in the comments too. And again, it's in no particular order. I'll just randomly share my five and you can do the same. Because we're all different. We're all attracted to different animals and different things for different reasons, which is what makes the world a really fun and amazing place. So go out, make it a happy day, and I'll, of course, be with you tomorrow. Bye.